qualities do you possess which will make you a good civil servant?
So I believe what I can draw at the outset from my legal experience is the ability to communicate, the ability to organize, the ability to convince, and the ability to delve into legal policy with clear language. This is at, you can say, the background level. At the ground level, I believe that my experience as a lawyer in terms of organizational and institutional discipline can add to the civil services.
Good.
Can you tell us about some judgments of the Supreme Court?
Yes.
Which has redefined the Constitution, given a new meaning to the Constitution.
So in any particular sphere or?
No. Basic constitutional issues,
right,
which has redefined our powers of the executive, legislative.
Right, sir. So the first judgment that is the locus classicus judgment, which added another whole new dimension to the Constitution, was the Keshavanand Bharati case, which added the concept of basic structure. It basically dealt with the legislature's power to amend the Constitution,
okay,
and it was limited to the basic structure. Then, sir, if we go a little forward, the relationship between fundamental rights and directive principles. It was determined in the Minerva Mills case. That is also considered a locus classicus judgment. Both of these, the spin-off came in Vaman Rao and I.R. Bohilo cases, where what used to happen was once the basic structure doctrine came into being, the legislature used to circumvent the process by adding it to the ninth schedule legislatures. So the I.R. Bohilo case, which is a nine judge bench, stated that post, affirmed Raman Rao, stated that post 24th April 1973, all the judgments that are added to the ninth schedule will also be checked for
open to review.
Yes, open to judicial review. Then, sir, of late, if we come to the recent judgments, we have three judgments which are in the previous year and the year before that. One is the NJAC judgment, which has spoken about the independence of judiciary and struck down the NJAC Act. Another case is the right to privacy judgment, the Justice Puttuswamy judgment, which came out last year, which has affirmed the right to privacy as a part of Article 21. And
was right to privacy not a fundamental right before this? What were the concerns?
So actually, the position of right to privacy was ambiguous. In the two cases of M.P. Sharma and Kharag Singh, actually there it was obiter, because what happened was that...
You are right. No, you are, I got that.
Yes, sir. So another judgment or regarding
another, if you have,
yes, sir. Of course, sir. Sir, the Sharia Banu judgment, triple talaq,
okay,
where two sets of majorities have come out. One led by Justice Keher, which said that Muslim law is personal law and protected under Article 25.
Okay.
However, the second majority, which was the real judgment, which said that triple talaq or instant triple talaq, talaq-e-bidat, has been declared unconstitutional.
Okay, now. Coming to this,
yes,
subsequently, the government came up with a law,
yes,
which is yet to come into force.
Yes.
Do you think there was a need for a law when triple talaq, instant triple talaq, means nothing after,
yes,
that judgment?
Yes, sir. What is usually seen is that a position of law with legislative backing has more force in terms of enforceability as well. Another thing is that perhaps the government saw this as a view, as a point towards moving towards uniform civil code in Article 44. So those were the twin purposes.
Why do we need to criminalize something,
yes,
which does not exist? Because after the Supreme Court judgment, it has no validity, nothing.
Yes, sir.
So why do we need to criminalize triple talaq?
So one of the theories is that punitive approach carries a deterrent effect. Now, if you criminalize it, then it will have a deterrent effect on people committing instant triple talaq.
Looking at the social reality.
Yes, yes. So the fear, the
okay,
fear of punishment is going to act as a deterrent.
Okay, RTI.
Yes.
What are your views on and legal position on political parties being brought within the ambit of RTI?
Sir, it has been a contentious issue till now. However, I believe since political parties are an embodiment of...
Are you aware of some CIC judgment on this?
So there was a recent, not so recent any longer, but there was a judgment on RTI and political parties, but I'm not sure of what exactly it said.
Okay, now tell us, there is a dispute between India and Pakistan at the ICJ.
Yes, sir.
There was initial legal hurdles which we crossed, and yes, there would be some legal issues involved subsequently. What are these?
Sir, the initial hurdles were whether ICJ had jurisdiction to hear a matter. Now, what happens is, under Article 36 of the ICJ statute, there are three ways of exercising ICJ jurisdiction.
And that don't go into that.
Yes. Sir, once ICJ accepted jurisdiction, which was opposed by Pakistan, ICJ assumed preliminary jurisdiction to hear the matter.
How did it bypass 36 declaration by India about Commonwealth nation being part?
Yes, sir. Sir, there's a principle called forum prorogatum, which is that once you, Pakistan and India have acceded, are parties to the ICJ statute. So once they have, they are parties to the ICJ statute, and there's a principle of customary international law involved, which is a part of the Vienna Convention on Consular Relations.
India has signed, and Pakistan has also signed, option protocol to the Vienna Convention.
Yes.
Which gives confers jurisdiction.
Yes.
Let's talk at that. Now, last question. Are you aware about this term? Judicial impact assessment. What purpose does it serve? Are you aware of this?
Sir, judicial impact assessment
there was
is
a report.
Yes, sir. It has been brought up in discourse of late. What happens is, sir, that once judgments are given by the Supreme Court or the High Court, judicial impact assessment will, you can say, there will be another body or another organization which will look at the impact of those judgments and whether the certitude of those judgments can be determined or not.
I'm afraid I don't think it's about the burden that laws will, new laws will put on the judiciary and for the delay in number of cases. Like we had 138 cases.
Right.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Vikramaditya.
Yes.
You are from Haryana.
Yes. So I was born in Haryana.
Okay.
I never lived here.
You know about the child sex ratio of Haryana?
Yes, sir.
Is it skewed?
Yes, sir, but it has been improving in the last 3 years. It has come to 914, I believe, per 1,000 males.
Even now it is skewed?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Even with 914, which it they have now,
sir. Yes, sir.
Come out with? Okay.
Yes, sir.
You know, Government of India have come out with some schemes. And also some act,
yes,
for prevention of female feticide,
yes,
as well as for welfare of the girl child.
Yes, sir.
Can you name them?
Yes, sir. Sir, the main scheme that was launched in Panipat, Haryana, by the PM was Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao.
Hmm.
The two acts, sir, there are two acts. One is prohibiting sex selection and one is prohibiting sex selective abortions. So, sex selection is the PCPNDT Act, which came in 1994 it came into force.
Mm.
And the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act, I think 1971,
mm,
that prohibits sex selective abortion.
Okay, that is about the prevention of the female sex.
Yes, yes.
And now that is being enforced rigorously.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
That is one then.
These are the two legislations, sir. Mm. The schemes include Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, as I said. Then there's Sukanya.
So Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, umbrella scheme.
Yes.
A number of projects.
Yes.
What are
so
those schemes?
Within that, there is, if you have Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana,
mm-hmm,
then you had movements like Selfie with Daughter in Haryana.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have Gudda Gudi boards.
Mm-hmm.
These are also
ICDS.
District. ICDS. Yes, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir.
And midday meal scheme.
Midday meal. So that is
for
a part of, yes,
it is not
for
girls. For girls,
yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. I would ask you about Swachh Bharat Abhiyan.
Yes, sir.
How it is very important, and what is the present progress?
Sir, it is important because as we have progressed as a society, we have seen that Swachhta has not been our main focus,
mm,
over the past few years.
Mm.
So it has wide-ranging impacts on our health, on our general standard of living, on our education, on how you see you know, even how we are perceived in the International Committee of Nations by the outsiders.
Okay.
So all those factors, which is why it's important.
Okay.
The progress, sir, in terms of rural sanitation, I believe the latest figures are that it was increased from 42 or 44% to 63%. So in the previous year's economic survey.
It came out all in newspaper.
Sir, 63% is...
No. 38% to 76%.
I stand corrected.
How many states and union territories have declared them open defecation free?
Sir, there are three states which are rural open declaration.
No, no. You are terribly short of figures. Read up. Okay,
yes,
now
sir.
I will come to something else.
Yes, sir.
What are the commonalities between these Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and Namami Gange? That is another.
Yes, sir.
There are some common.
Yes, sir. Sir, Namami Gange, the commonality, outright commonality is that Namami Gange includes Swachh Bharat around the Ganga grounds.
Mm.
So that is the outright commonality. But of course, the base is that they both look at cleanliness.
Correct.
Namami Gange with respect to Ganga and Swachh Bharat with respect to our rural and urban living.
That is one then.
The other is, sir, Swachh Bharat has open defecation free, whereas Namami Gange also looks at effluence within the river. It looks at how our industries along the river are.
That is all. They are the components of the scheme.
Yes, sir.
The commonality one you mentioned clearly. Another,
yes, sir.
You know, the behavioral change.
Sorry, sir.
Behavioral change.
Right, sir.
You know, the
attitudinal
change.
Attitudinal change. Yes.
Okay, thank you.
You have a very impressive bio data. How many courses, how many gold medals, publications and sports?
Yes.
What should I ask you from? Tell me about your research paper,
right,
which was published.
Ma'am, I can start with one on the doctrine of, on the concepts of tying and bundling. Or I can start...
No, what is this concept?
Ma'am, it comes under the Competition Act. The principle is, the main case from which it spun off was the Microsoft and Internet Explorer case in the European court and antitrust legislation in the US. So what happens is where service providers with their main product, they, you know, as a bundle, they tie various other products which consumers are forced to buy. So
here if I asked you, tell me something about net neutrality,
yes,
what would you say?
Ma'am, net neutrality is treating data on the internet as all equal. It is no...
So there was this free basics,
yes,
and...
free basics and Airtel Zero.
What was all that about?
Ma'am, what happened was that, for example, Facebook, free basics, with their Facebook account, they were tying a lot of peripheral applications which came free along with usage of Facebook for people. Now, that would have ideally... For Facebook, it was a commercial interest, but for users, access was discriminatory.
So would it be a deterrent for some of the startups? Would they be,
yes,
a disadvantage?
It is perceived as a deterrent because they would have to enter into a revenue sharing agreement with Facebook.
Okay. Now you also played a lot of games.
Yes.
Played squash.
Yes.
How is it that India is not doing so well in this area? Pakistan and Afghanistan,
yes,
their teams are doing so much,
yes,
better. Why?
Ma'am, one is that we have quite focused on cricket as our main sport. Historically hockey, but not any longer.
Yes.
The other is the institutional support and the organizational support is not as much as it is in the other sports.
So in cricket, since you mentioned cricket, we had lots of problems with the BCCI.
Yes, ma'am.
So do you think the Lodha Committee recommendations are going to help cricket?
Ma'am, I believe it's a good start, because we did see cricket administration being, it had a lot of ills in the system in terms of MPs and bureaucrats serving long tenures, there being conflicts of interest. So on those principles, I believe what has been stated by the Lodha Committee is in the right direction.
Now, you're from Haryana.
Yes.
We hear of the cups.
Yes,
and we hear of honor killing, some social problems,
yes,
evils.
Yes,
what is your view on the cups?
Ma'am, actually, historically, cups were, they played a positive role in the society.
And present day?
Present, unfortunately, the elements that you can say have taken over the cup panchayats, they have negative spillovers in the society.
So has the Supreme Court said anything regarding the caste?
Yes, ma'am. Recently, the Supreme Court, I believe yesterday or day before, the Supreme Court has observed, it's not really a judgment,
yes,
but the Supreme Court has observed that castes have no right to interfere in marriage. But one of the arguments that was brought on was that you know how even the Hindu Marriage Act talks about Sapinda and Sagotra.
Mm-hmm.
So that talks about 5 degrees on the father's side and 3 degrees on the mother's side. So the argument is that either you change the law or you permit marriages. But that said, ma'am, I think the Supreme Court is right in pointing out that it is a personal choice.
Okay. Now, there's this problem with the Yamuna Satluj Link Canal.
Yes.
What is the present status?
Ma'am, the present status is that Punjab, after the new government came in, has withdrawn the idea of their legislation. They had to bring about a legislation, and Punjab has said that they will not. And they will not, they've severed any proposal of sharing of the canal as
and
such.
And they've also started returning the land to the
farmers. Yes.
Now, last question, Niti Aayog.
Yes.
Are you aware of it?
Yes.
What is its main function?
Ma'am, I believe it has two laterals.
Mm-hmm.
One is focused on cooperative federalism,
yes,
which is dealing with the states and engaging states and bringing states on board in the government of India's programs.
Mm-hmm.
And the other is their knowledge or policy think tank role.
Alright, good. Thank you.
Right, I'll ask you a few questions. Which agency or institution in India has been in the forefront in curbing criminalization of politics?
Sir, in terms of a non-government organization, we have the Association of Democratic Reforms, which brings out facts and figures. But if you say which organization, it's the Supreme Court, which through its judgments has attempted
to... Name some judgments. Landmark judgments in this case.
So the recent landmark judgment was a Lily Thomas case where they struck down Section 8.4 of the Representation of People Act 1951.
Right, that was one.
So one was when they brought in the nota, none of the above option. One was Jan Chaukidar's case.
The latest judgment?
Sir, the bar of 6 years plus conviction came in the Lily Thomas case, which is...
That is known.
Which, yes, sir.
Latest last year, towards in October, November, there was another step it took.
Sir, in which direction?
Special courts.
Yes, sir. To set up 12 fast-track courts, okay, for...
Yes, it was...
It was chasing
the government,
yes,
to establish.
Yes.
Government had to,
yes,
send the recommendation. It is approved. Right?
That's right, sir.
Okay. What is UNCLOS, UNCLOS?
Yes, sir.
Very brief.
Yes, sir. So UNCLOS is the United Nations Convention on Law of the Sea. It was brought into force in 1994, drafted in 1982.
How many countries have accepted it?
So I don't know the exact number.
Is it voluntary or it is mandatory?
So all conventions are voluntary, but UNCLOS is also drafting of what was believed or considered by the ICJ as already embodiment of customary international law principles. So, but of course, Article 21A of the Vienna Convention on Law of Treaty says that any convention is voluntary for every country. So,
what is the Supreme Court's position on branded drugs and generic drugs? What is its latest position and what was that judgment?
Yes, sir. So I'll start with the judgment. It was a Novartis case where Glivec, its prime anti-cancer drug, was not granted its secondary.
What was the judgment? Briefly.
So the judgment is on evergreening, which is Section 3D of the Patents Act, which is where they've said that any drug that has to continue its patent needs to have an appreciable improved impact.
Efficacy,
apart from what its original drug
it can't be only an incremental.
Yes, sir. And Glivec was only a beta crystalline form of it.
Got it.
Yes.
Now, Google has been fined, you must have read, 136 crores.
Right, sir.
What is the reason it has been fined?
Right, sir. Sir, I believe it has been, I'm sorry, sir, I'm not sure, but if I am maybe in the right direction, I believe it's because of its search engine being monitored to Google's favored search results. That was the main issue.
They call it search bias.
Search bias. Yes.
It creates a search bias.
Yes, sir.
Now, is it does it conflict with the principle of net neutrality? This particular thing. This judgment. Whatever the finding of the CCI.
Yes, sir. Sir, prima facie, any meddling with treatment of the internet or data does conflict with net neutrality. That said, sir, Google.
Who controls internet?
Sir, the internet is governed by ICANN, which is, it used to be dominated by US government, but now it has been, after Dilma Rousseff from Brazil's initiation, it has been an independent organization.
Correct. What is global commons?
Sir, global commons are, say, for example, you have the high seas, which are considered as common.
High seas? Just name,
yes.
Bullet.
Yes, sir. Sir, high seas, space,
outer space.
Yes, sir. Outer space. Then within the high seas, you have all your minerals which are vested, which are also considered as global commons. Of course, the International Seabed Authority under the UNCLOS monitors them, but they are considered as global commons.
What else?
I can't think of any other moment. Perhaps
cyberspace.
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Internet.
Yes, sir.
Antarctic region?
Sorry, sir?
Antarctic
region. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Now, recently there is some conflict. Lawyers cannot be MPs or vice versa. MPs cannot do law practice.
Sir, there's a proposition.
What is this case now?
Sir, there's a proposition to...
Who has filed this case?
I'm not aware of
who's
filed. I'm not aware of who's filed.
Some BJP MP, I think.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. We close the matter here.